Deliverance. Hallelujah. We say good morning to you today. Hallelujah. This is Choice Radio 92.9 FM. You are listening to the Hour of Healing with Pastor Ignatius Lalit and Pastor John Blackman. Praise the name of the Lord. We thank God for allowing you, us, to come into your homes, to come into your living room, into your bedrooms, into your cars. Hallelujah. We greet you in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Those of you that are listening to the radio, through the internet, on your phone, we want to greet you in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you are this morning, praise God. We trust that God, the Holy Ghost, will minister to you today. Hallelujah. As you open your heart to receive from Almighty God. Hallelujah. Call a neighbor, call a friend. Tell them the hour of healing is on the air. Hallelujah. This may be your hour of healing. This may be your hour of deliverance. Today, hallelujah, might be your day of deliverance. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. We thank God this morning that we are able to come to you. Hallelujah. Through Jesus Christ, we thank God this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. We praise God this morning for Hallelujah. This wonderful opportunity yeah. where we can minister into your situation today. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise At this time, God. We're going to begin with prayer as we usually do. Hallelujah. And Pastor Alink is going to pray for us today. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Good morning to all our Choice Radio listeners. We greet you in Jesus' name. And we are about to dedicate this segment with the word of prayer. And we will ask you to join us together. Just take even a couple of minutes and let us just
Hallelujah.
Lift up the name of Jesus Christ this morning. And Father God, we thank you for this blessed day that you have given to us. We thank you for waking us up to see, Lord, this brand new day. You know, Father, we thank you. We know that each day have its own blessing and its own trouble. But Father God, we thank you that you is the Lord, the God of heaven, the one that, Lord, that create all things. And we know that God, that you hold every man's life in your hand. And Father God, we thank you in the name of Jesus that you have given to us a name that is above every name.
Hallelujah.
And at the name of Jesus Christ, we can come boldly to the throne of grace because of the sacrificial blood, hallelujah, of the Lamb this morning. Father God, we thank you, O God, today for your goodness, your kindness, your love, and your mercy. We thank you, O God, this morning, Lord, for the peace that passeth all
Hallelujah.
Understanding. We thank you, O God, today, that God Almighty, for your great love, where you have loved us so much. And my God, you love the world that you gave your only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but shall have everlasting life.
Hallelujah.
I thank God this morning. I thank you. And Father, we pray, O God, that you will sanctify, you will, O God, uphold this radio station this morning. I pray that God, Lord, that we may continue to use for the purpose that it was intended to use for, the preaching of the gospel to reach the nation, O God, of the earth. Father God, we asking of you, Lord, loose the management team. And O God and Lord, we pray that you will give them wisdom and understanding. Lord, we pray in the time of battle, in the time, O God, when there is struggle and trials in the life,
yes.
That you will uphold them by your spirit and keep them, O God, hallelujah, to function according to thy will. We pray that you will keep your hand on every piece of instrument as we speak the blood
yes,
of Jesus,
Jesus
over this station. My God, this morning we pray, oh God, as this Lord as broadcasting go out to the nation, that my God, we pray for those that listening, oh God,
yes.
to the Lord, the broadcasting on the radio. We pray that you will continue to cause this radio, oh God, working, and let them help them to get the right reception. And Father God, we bind the works of the enemy
Hallelujah.
In the atmosphere that seem, oh God, to tamper with the reception, oh God, of this radio program. I bind it in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I command the reception to loose by the power of the Most High God. And those that listening, oh God, hallelujah, by the phone, that you will cause the phone to be working in right condition.
Yes,
and to those, my God, that is on the website, I pray that God, that you will continue to cause the internet to work in properly. And my God, that Lord, they will hear and that they will receive a word this morning. They will receive a word of healing.
They receive a word of deliverance. They will receive a word of exhortation. And my God, this morning, hallelujah, we thank you for the opportunity, oh God, to get into the homes of the hearer this morning. We thank you for those, oh God, who tune into the station. And oh God, what the station really mean to them. Hallelujah. What we believe, oh God, that you have ordained the station for the purpose of the preaching of the gospel to reach, oh God, the lost at any cost. We thank you, oh God, this morning that you will breathe upon all the hearer this morning the holy anointing power of the Holy Ghost. Lord, without the Holy Ghost, they would not aim to understand your word. You said, oh God, in Proverbs 20, at my reproof, and I will make my word known. I will pour out my spirit upon you, and I will make my word known unto you. And my God, we know without the Holy Ghost that lead the writer to write, oh God, we're not able to understand what the Bible is saying. But we believe it is the manual, oh God, God have given unto us his manual, so that we can see how to function as we take the maker manual. And my God, I pray every nation under heaven will, oh God, have a copy of the maker manual, and they will look into it, hallelujah, and see how they ought to function. And my God, we realize in this last days that, oh God, there is so much malfunctioning in families, in government, and oh God, hallelujah, in institution, and in the home. My God, this morning, I pray that God and the devil have his field day, oh God, in infiltrating their family because they don't have knowledge of the functioning according to thy manual. But Father God, we pray that, Lord, that as the gospel go forth, Jesus Christ, you declare this gospel must preach into all the world as a witness unto all men. This good news must be preached. You declare that they will see and understand that the maker give a manual that we should learn how to function. And my God, this morning, in Jesus' name, we pray that you will cause your word to go forth over the government leaders, oh God, over, my God, every institution. You will cause your word to go forth in every nation as men begin to sacrifice by the call of you to declare the unsearchable riches of the glory of God this morning. Father God, we pray that, Lord, as men take your manual, they will see and they will understand your promises. Oh God, we pray, hallelujah, that my God, you will touch every listener under the riches of oh God voice this morning. I pray that God, you will break yokes of sickness and disease. I curse it in the name of Jesus. I bind the works of the enemy, my God, hallelujah, and they will take the report that Jesus Christ have declared the good news, and they will, oh God, guard themselves of the report the doctor give them, the report, oh God, of the OBN and the witchcraft worker, my God, and they will take the report of Almighty God, hallelujah, for there is power in the report, there is victory in that report, hallelujah. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, as has declared, who shall believe of a report? For the Bible declared to him, the arm of the Lord is revealed unto her, and the arm of the Lord is revealed unto every nation, unto every kindred and tongue. And my God, we pray today that you will release your power and break the shackle in the atmosphere, bringing on the prince of the power of the air, and liberating the souls of men and women everywhere in the name of Jesus Christ this morning. Could somebody lift your voice this morning? Somebody call upon his name. Could somebody join together and get your deliverance this morning? Father, I send by the Holy Ghost the power of deliverance, a word of deliverance, yes, in every home, in every car, in every offices, yes, in, oh God, in every, hallelujah, on the street. My God, this morning we take, oh God, Lord, we take authority over the atmosphere, hallelujah, of the homes and of the family of every hearer, and we bind the prince of the power of the air. We curse the works of evil. We command them to be free. We command them to be released by the power of God this morning. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, the Savior of the world, and the soon coming King. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Somebody washing God this morning. Glory to God. This morning. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
My God, this morning, as we face, oh God, this atmosphere of war, as we face, oh God, the threat that coming from the west, oh God, from the east to the west, my God, we pray as America, my God, encounter with a threat, my God, to launch, oh God, a war, my God, I pray that you will give the leaders, oh God, of the nation direction, Father, I pray that God, remember the innocent people, Jesus, that go not die, oh God, by the hand of a dictator, but God Almighty, you have a way in which that you can reach those, oh God, who continue to play with human life, and oh God, against nature, and my God, I know that you have, oh God, tried, oh God, hallelujah, the king of Babylon, and God, you have showed him that you is the God of heaven, oh God, shedding him and give him a heart as an animal to live out in the dew for 7 years until in Noah, the God of heaven ruleth over the children of men. And my God, I thank you that you teach his son, my God, hallelujah, when he rejoices and claim himself to be a God, that you send a writing on the wall and cause him to come down and smooth his heart. My God, I pray that the earth belong to you and the country and, oh God, the nation. And I pray that every dictator, my God, in our nation, every leader that claim himself to be God and destroy the innocent life that you have created, God, I know, I speak judgment to go forth. Lord, oh God, we don't want a bomb. We don't want an invent, oh God, Lord, an intervention, oh God, of human bomb. But God, we ask you for a divine intervention instead. Where, oh God, those that break the rules, those that come against, oh God, and those that use the gun and the sword, oh God, shall be perished by the very thing that they have used. I pray that God, hallelujah, save the life of the innocent one, by the, oh God, by the bomb, and my God, the threat of war. And oh God, I pray, oh God, that we join together with the saint for a divine intervention into, my God, the life of those that take human life and again, oh God, have no mercy. I pray that God, you will intervene in the palace, you will intervene in the bed, and my God, you will bring justice, and God, you will raise up a man that fear that name and call upon your name, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray for peace in this earth. I pray for peace in America. I pray for peace in the Lord, on the nation of the earth. I pray for peace around the borders of Israel. I pray for peace, my God, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Oh my God, we thank you today, Lord, for hearing our prayer. We thank you, oh God. Give, oh God, direction to the Lord, to the Senator and the House, that they will make the right decision.
Hallelujah.
But Father God, we thank you that you is able. You is able to bring judgment. You is able to judge, my God, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And we pray, instead of destruction, we pray that the Holy Ghost will go forth and convict the nation, and convict men and women to return and repent, oh God. Hallelujah. For oh God, that Lord, in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Glory to
Lord,
God.
Lord, you just
glory
have your God way. Have your
glory
way
to God.
Have your way, my God.
Hallelujah.
Have mercy and compassion upon the
praise
ignorant.
The name of
have
God
mercy and compassion
oh
upon
God
men, oh God, Jesus, who are ignorant, my God, concerning life. My God, we ask you to release your power and your glory over the lives,
yes,
and draw, oh God, every soul under the riches of the man of the gospel preaching this morning.
Hallelujah.
That they will come to, oh God, that place of conviction, the place where they will repent of this sin, repent of this sin,
Jesus,
before it's too late. God, you declare in your word is appointed unto men once to die,
yes,
and after death come the judgment. And Father, we pray, oh God, that Lord, as you hold the power of life and death, I pray that man will come down. Conviction will take place this morning.
Hallelujah.
Over this, oh hallelujah, this broadcasting segment, and many fathers, many wives, and many sons and daughters will bow unto the Lordship of Jesus Christ, and to save their life from eternal damnation. Oh God, the lake of fire, my God, we asking of you to loose the Christian that continue
Jesus
to walk crooked, oh God, and continue to play with the life, taking the name of
hallelujah
the Lord in vain. Father, we pray that you will shaken them. God, you will bring conviction upon the soul.
Hallelujah.
My God, you will turn them. We pray for every minister of the gospel,
Jesus,
those that fear thy name, that you will increase, oh God, your favor and your grace upon them to do according to thy will. And to those who have taken on themselves and placed themselves in a position that you didn't call them, I pray you will bring them to the
hallelujah
dead end of the road. My God, they will be ashamed of themselves and repent. Oh God, we pray that you will bring to light those that walk with the deceptive spirit.
Jesus.
Those, oh God, among the brethren who, oh God, walk in deception. Those who take the gospel
hallelujah
and make it among the Lord and merchandise on people, oh God, for their own gain. Bring them to light. Oh God, I pray that judgment
Jesus
will come, oh God, upon all men who continue to hold the truth, oh God, into lie, and oh God, Lord, and become stumbling block in other way, and my God, become, oh my God, and making, oh God, people to fold the child of hell. My God, this morning,
hallelujah,
I pray that God, hallelujah, your justice hand will stretch towards them, and let the Holy Ghost convict them,
Jesus,
and convert them and turn them wrong.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we just give you praise. And Father, today we consecrate this station.
Hallelujah.
Lord, today by the
in
holy
the
anointed
Jesus
power, in the name of
in
Jesus,
name
could
of
somebody
Jesus
just lift your voice,
hallelujah,
and give
hallelujah
him praise. Give your voice and
glory
worship him
God
this morning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus
blessed
Christ.
Be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of
thank
the Lord
you.
We give God glory
hallelujah
this morning. Praise the name of the Lord. We thank God this morning for this opportunity. Praise God. We
amen
can come to you today. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. Amen. The Lord is wonderful.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. We want to take our announcements at this time before we go
praise
into the word. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm Pastor Blackman, a pastor of Truth and Light Ministries. And Truth and Light, we are located at 485 Rogers Avenue between Midwood and Maple. Praise the name of the Lord. Our time of fellowship is Sunday morning at 9 a.m. Sunday morning at 9 a.m. You can come fellowship with us. Praise the name of the Lord. We celebrate the Lord together. We are a group of fun-loving Christians, believers in Christ, who are filled with love. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You come and you meet the brethren, you cannot help but experience the embrace of love from their hearts. Praise God. And we encourage you to come at Sunday morning, 9 a.m. is our time of fellowship. Hallelujah. And then on Tuesday evening at 7:30, we meet for a prayer and Bible study where we come together. Hallelujah. Go before the throne of God, where we come together and study the word of God and be instructed in the word of God. Amen.
Yeah.
The Bible declared that we shall not forsake the assembling of ourselves together, as the manner of some is. Hallelujah. You need to be counseled. You need to be taught the word. Praise the name of the Lord. And we go to homes. You want us to come to your home to study the word, to minister to your situation. You can call us. Praise the name of the Lord. We also go to homes for counseling. You can call us for counseling, for ministry in your home. If you want your home to be dedicated to the service of God, you can call us. Praise the name of the Lord. You can reach me at 201-314-0666. That's 201-314-0666. Praise the name of the Lord. We also have coming up, praise God, appreciation and anniversary service for my dear friend Pastor Ignatius Lalit. Praise the name of the Lord. This would be on Saturday, praise God, September 28th. That's Saturday, September 28th at 4 p.m. And the venue is New Life Church of God Fellowship Hall on 379-81 Empire Boulevard. 379-81 Empire Boulevard, between Nostrand and New York Avenue. Praise God. Don't miss it. Praise God. You have heard the man of God on the air. He has ministered to you. Some of you have called. Hallelujah. We want to show appreciation while he's alive. Amen. Praise God. Sometimes when someone passed away, we cry and we give flowers and we say, what a good person. We want to do that while the person is here with us. So come and celebrate with us. Come celebrate the man of God with us on Saturday, September 28th at 4 p.m. And that's 379-81 Empire Boulevard between Nostrand and New York Avenue. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We also have a computer class. Our computer class will be starting this Monday, September 9th. At 7 p.m., praise the name of the Lord. We want to invite you to come. The classes are free. Amen. Yes, you heard me. There is no charge for the classes. If you already have a laptop, a notebook, you can come with it. But our orientation is Monday, September 9th, first day of our class. Our classes would be on Mondays and Thursdays, between 7 to 9 p.m. Praise the name of the Lord. We are filling up quickly, Pastor Lalit. So I encourage you to be there on Monday. And the address is 1509. That's 1509 Nostrand Avenue. Hallelujah. That's Pastor Lalit's location, between Church and Erasmus. Praise the name of the Lord. Between Church and Snyder. Amen. Between Snyder and Erasmus, whichever you prefer. But it's on the left after you leave Church Avenue, right after you pass Erasmus. So come and learn about the computer. We are living in a computerized age. Every phone is a computer now. Praise God. Some of you, the phone you have, you don't know, but it is a computer. Hallelujah. So you need to learn it. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. And we have one more announcement. Kimrick Daycare and Learning Center. You have a child between the ages of 2 to 6 years old. Hallelujah. You can call them. They provide a safe, happy, and caring environment for children. Praise God. Very convenient to transportation. You get the B35, the B44, and the 2 and 5 trains. Praise God. The hours of operation are 7:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Praise the name of the Lord. You can call them, and they are located on 1509 Nostrand Avenue on street level. Praise God, between Church and Snyder. And you can reach them at 646-393-9181. That's 646-393-9181. 8:1. God bless you this morning.
Amen. Hallelujah. And I'm the pastor of Aubrey Church, New Beginning Ministry. And on the same location that where the computer class is taking place, 1509 Nostrand Avenue. And it is between Snyder and Erasmus. Most people say Snyder and Church because Erasmus is a short street end of Nostrand. Hallelujah. And we invite you to come to fellowship with us. If you don't have a Bible-believing church, or if you, amen, for some reason you had some problem and you sit at home, you stop going to church, it is not good to be in the sight of God. Amen. We're living in dangerous time and we need to get up and arise. Hallelujah. So we invite you to our fellowship on Sunday morning, every Sunday morning, 11 a.m. Hallelujah. We have a wonderful Sunday school for adults and the young children. Hallelujah. And we invite you, amen, to come. Bring your children, come, and let them learn what the Word of God said. Let them learn at a very tender age. And we also have, amen, some wonderful teachers who really outline the Word and make you feel happy and put knowledge into your heart. And we want to invite you, so come on Sunday morning, 11 a.m. Hallelujah. And on Wednesday we have our Bible study and prayer meeting. Hallelujah. This month we designate this month as a month of prayer. Hallelujah. Amen. Get in, amen, to pray. Hallelujah. In all the services we have and in our private devotion, a time of intensive prayer. If there's a time we need to pray, it's now. Hallelujah. So on Wednesday 7 p.m. and on Friday 7 p.m. we continue, amen, this great time of prayer. And you that have family problem, you have, amen, problem with, amen, your business and whatever situation that arises. Hallelujah. You have problem with your children, amen, back home and in your country. We invite you to bring the picture, come, and bring whatever document that you haven't struggled with. Bring it, come. We're going to lay it on the altar. We're going to bring it before the throne of grace. And I guarantee you that God will answer. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Don't forget, hallelujah, we continue, amen. And as Pastor Blackman said, that we have the computer class. The transportation is very easy. Amen. We have the B44 come down on Nostrand. Hallelujah. And we also have the 3 train, the 2 train, and the 5 train. Amen. Stop at the church and just a block away, and you can come down. Hallelujah. Come to that place. Amen. And fellowship. Hallelujah. This morning we just give God praise. We want Hallelujah. To say hi to my wife, amen, Alice, and to all Outreach members. We want to say hi to you. We love you. And to all, amen, KBS, and we was by KBS amen. On day Thursday, and we had a wonderful time. We had a great time this week as the celebration, hallelujah, of the anniversary coming up on Sunday evening. Hallelujah. Amen. And you heard it over the air. We trust in God for a great time on Sunday evening. Hallelujah. So we give God the praise. Hi, DJ Vibe and Sister Parton. Amen. And Double O and his wife. We thank God for, amen, for having such people among us. Amen. And all to those who on the radio program here, those in the morning and those in the night and the midday, we thank God for every one of you. And we want to say, we just want, you know, to encourage you to press on, to move on. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And do what God have you to do. Praise Amen. Praise Hallelujah. God. Praise God.
Praise the name Amen. Of the Lord. Hallelujah. We want to say hi to the all the Truth and Light Ministry brethren. Praise the name of the Lord. The family of Truth and Light. Praise the name of the Lord. We want to also again congratulate Pastor Roberts, Elder Roberts, 2 years of celebration. Amen. Amen. It seems like yesterday.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. But they're celebrating 2 years.
Yeah.
They now have a toddler on their hand. Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. And you know, what toddlers do. Yeah. Amen. They can, sometimes they can strip the place apart. But we thank God this morning. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. We thank God for 2 years of celebration of KBS. May the Lord continue to bless and minister to this ministry.
Praise
Hallelujah.
God.
May the Lord continue to strengthen. Hallelujah. May the Lord continue to establish you.
Praise
Hallelujah. God. Hallelujah. And Pastor Roberts, may the Lord continue to work in you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
As you continue, praise the name of the Lord, to stand fast.
Yeah.
To stand firm on the rock. Hallelujah. Who is Christ? As you continue to minister the word, may the Lord continue to establish you and to remove the boundaries. Praise the name of the Lord. And to continue to lead and to direct you as you yield to his service. Amen.
And also praise to Sister Robert, you know.
Amen. First lady.
You cannot leave out. Amen. The first lady. Amen. We are part of
Amen.
This whole
Amen.
Teamwork.
Amen.
Amen.
It's teamwork.
Hallelujah.
Teamwork.
And we thank God for
Hallelujah.
Having such a people like them.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Among
Hallelujah.
Us. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And
Amen.
All the ministers' wife, we the ministers and the wife, we thank
yes.
God for you. Amen. Wives, we thank God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. And I tell you that sometimes the wives and them, I mean, they really do a good job.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. One thing they could remember. Amen.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Thing that you forget, they can remember.
Amen.
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 Thing that you can handle, sometimes they step in and
Amen.
Now they handle it. Amen.
Amen.
But thank God for them. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank God for
Hallelujah.
Them.
Hallelujah.
I just want to say hi to my son Joel and his wife in England and his children and amen. I want to let you know that Dad love you. And to Janel, Jesse, Jerry, Jenny, and Hallelujah, and Terrence in Grenada, and these Jenny and Jolly G's in Trinidad, and our grandchildren Kimberly Kelly and amen Jaddy and Gerard. We want to say Grandpa love you and amen. Hallelujah. Know you that you listen to us at this time. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So God, this morning, we just want to get into the word. We
Amen.
Want to get
Amen.
Your Bible out. And we want to take time, this amen, and share the word,
yes.
amen, with you. This is the makeup manual. And we want to share it with you that, amen, that we will function right. Hallelujah. You see, when the devil come around, he look. Amen. Where he can find something in us. And if he find we're not walking in the word, then he go out
yes.
and get some other friend of his, some team, amen, a teammate and team partner. Amen. Hallelujah. And they come back and they start to, amen, set up blockade for you and start to tempt you.
Amen.
So, amen. We want to share with you this morning in the word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we
amen.
Continue, amen, in the topic. Hallelujah. Amen. The cares of this life.
Yes.
Amen. The cares of this life. Because Jesus said the cares of this life, draw them away from me.
Yes.
Draw them away from me. And we want to, amen, continue this morning as Pastor Blackman read today the scripture. Hallelujah.
Amen. We want to look into Philippians this morning. Philippians chapter 4. Praise the name of
Praise
the Lord.
God.
Verses 4-7. Praise God. The word of God says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, Paul speaking, rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And he says, the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Be careful for some things. For nothing. Pastor Lalit, we have so many people that go around on a daily basis with anxiety. over sometimes lack, over sometimes things that they would like to have or to accomplish. And they go around with a sense of anxiety, maybe because they have deadlines to accomplish certain things. You hear women sometimes say, I'm getting old and I want a baby. And they become anxious.
Yeah.
And you hear sometimes people say, young people say, listen, I need to get my degree before such and such time. And they become anxious. And some people say, I need to get a house before such and such time. And they become anxious and frustrated. And the job they're doing, they don't like it. And they're looking, you know, unsuccessfully for another job. And they become anxious. But what does the word of God teach? The Bible says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything. That's the key, you know.
Yeah, everything.
In everything. What we should do? First, pray.
Yeah.
Supplication. Thanksgiving. And then, let your requests be made known unto God.
Yeah.
What do we do the majority of the time? The first thing we do, Pastor, is we put that list before God.
Hallelujah.
The cart before the horse. But the Bible gives us a strategy.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The Bible gives us a strategy. You see, when we seek God first, the word of God declares that if we put him first,
yeah,
say seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And he said, then what? All things shall be added. You know, yeah. Pastor, many times we don't have to go before God and make requests because God already know what we know. But if we put him first, if we seek him first, if we seek to do his will, and many times God is speaking to us, and God is asking us to do certain things, and we disobeying his command, we violating his ordinances, but yet we want him to bless us.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We're not doing what he's asking us to do, but we want him to bless us. And when things don't work out the way that we want it to do, it is not about you, it is not about me. Is about what God wants for our lives.
Hallelujah.
Who tell you that God wants you to buy that house at this time? Or to own that car? Or to change that job? Maybe God have you in that job for a specific purpose. Have you ever thought about that? Maybe you're there, you should be ministering to people and you're not. But you're getting frustrated. Why not start ministering to people? Those around you. Why not start ministering to them and trying to give them the word of God? Why not try doing that first? And then maybe, just maybe, God will open a door. And God will just, you don't have to look for a job. You know, Pastor, in all my years, you know, I've always had, almost every year, people call me and offer me a job.
Yeah.
And I turn it down. When you yield your service to God, I tell people, God is no man's debtor. Don't owe anybody. God don't keep books. Amen. He don't keep books. Only the book of life.
Hallelujah.
But God don't keep account books. So when we do service to God, God will minister to your situation. You don't have to go begging and you don't have to go asking God. God already know. Yeah. He's able to put you somewhere else.
Yeah.
Amen. So be anxious. Be careful. But he said in prayer and supplication, let your requests be made known. And the peace of God that passeth all understanding. Sometimes we get so frustrated. We allow the enemy to rob us of our peace. Yeah. Amen. We allow the enemy to take our peace. Because of where we are and the cares of life. You know, it's designed to rob us of our peace, Pastor.
Yeah.
It's designed to take away the comfort. that God wants us to experience. But we fall for it and we allow the enemy to rob us. Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, the enemy, there's an enemy who target every man, whether he's a Christian or not. Hallelujah. He's seeking to destroy. His job is to kill, steal, and to destroy. And he don't come, amen, hallelujah, with a gun to blow your head off. He come with his trick. He come with his strategy.
Yes.
Paul said that you may know the wiles of the enemy, your enemy. Your enemy is the devil. And I look at this passage that you read, Pastor Blackman, and it starts with joy. Rejoice in the Lord.
Yes.
Always and again I say rejoice. Hallelujah. What the writer is saying here, he passed through it.
Yes.
Paul, the apostle, who went through so much thing, more than you and I, he was able to maintain himself, hallelujah, with the joy. You remember when he was in prison, he and Silas, and they have all right to worry the whole night, according to the human flesh, according to the human sight. Hallelujah. After all the treatment they have given to them, and they put them in stocks, and they handcuff them, and they put the food in stocks, and they have them in that dark cell. But the Bible tells me that these men know how to keep, to maintain that joy.
Yes.
To maintain that joy. You see, the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Amen.
And if the devil could tempt us to move out from our strength, it means that we are going to be weakened.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And when you're in a state of weakness, it's very difficult for you to do anything. It is very difficult for you to maintain peace. It is very difficult for you to maintain love.
Amen.
Because you are in a state of weakness. Hallelujah. So Paul and Silas, they, hallelujah, what they do? They pray. They sing songs of praises. Hallelujah. And inside that prison cell, hallelujah, they make it a room of praise.
Amen.
Amen. They commune together with God. Hallelujah. And they continue to experience the joy. The joy. So the writer who write this letter and giving it to us, he giving us a secret. A secret weapon, a divine weapon against the enemy. He giving us, amen, a strategy.
Yes.
How that we can protect ourselves from the vicious attack of the enemy to chew on worries.
Hallelujah.
And to chew on the cares of this life on us. Hallelujah. And I love that, Pastor Blackman.
Amen.
My radio listener, I love that. Because when you're rejoicing, you're in a place, hallelujah, in an atmosphere with you and God, and you care less about anything.
Mm-hmm.
Once you begin to rejoice, the pains of life seem to be dissipated.
Amen. Amen.
The pangs of life move away.
Amen.
Hallelujah. When they sing songs of praises in that prison cell, and some of you, amen, you're not, amen, maybe in a physical, amen, a prison cell, but you built up wall, amen, around you. The cares of this life has caused you to focus on things that, amen, that cause you to build wall around
Hallelujah.
You and build yourself and lock yourself in a prison cell. Hallelujah. And when I say a prison cell, it means that you're not free to do what you Amen. Are to Amen. Do. Amen. You're not free to go out. You're not free to meet some people. You're not free to go to church. You're not free to read your Bible. You're not free, amen, to pray. Hallelujah. Because the cares of this life, you have taken on so much that you build walls around you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Now Paul and amen, Paul and his fellow workers, Paul and Silas, yes, they was, amen, in a natural prison cell.
Yes.
And they could have built a prison cell, amen, amen. Inside that cell around them. Hallelujah. And they could have been just wondering and praying, God, why we should be here? Why, amen, we are going through the suffering after we preaching, after we minister, we doing your will. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But it happened, amen, for a divine purpose. It happened that we might learn today that, amen, in spite of whatever prison cell, hallelujah, whatever the devil try to bring us, attack hallelujah. Us with, amen, that there is power in the name of the Lord to defuse
amen.
Every
amen.
Work of the devil.
Amen.
Because I heard the Bible said, for amen, for this purpose the Son of God
yes.
was manifested that he might destroy the yes. work of the
amen.
Devil.
Amen.
And for my amen, for me, the works of the devil have been destroyed for me on Calvary.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. And I don't have to worry. I don't have to be afraid. Hallelujah. I may, amen, I may, amen, hallelujah, be shattered for a night, but I know joy cometh in the morning.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Weeping may endure for a night, my brother and my sister. Amen. But joy cometh in the morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. And why,
praise
amen,
God.
Paul and Silas maintain the joy of the Lord. So they have right. They experience what the joy of the Lord is all about.
Yes.
Amen. They experience the secret in tapping the joy. Amen. Hallelujah. Because God dwell in the praises of
Hallelujah.
His people. When you begin to praise God in your situation, my friend, this morning, instead of worrying what's going to happen, instead of you taking time and praying against the devil, hallelujah, God give you a weapon to use. Use it in the name of the Lord, and rejoice and be glad exceedingly. Hallelujah, for great is your reward. Oh, amen, hallelujah. Amen, be careful for nothing. You see, everything that God tell us not to, amen, there is a boundary line, there
amen.
Is a red line, there is danger. Don't overstep that boundary line, because you will be in trouble. Hallelujah. Paul and Silas already in trouble, Pastor Blackman.
Yeah.
What else? Hallelujah. Amen. I'm willing to die, amen, in that condition. Hallelujah. For the gospel preaching.
Yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah. What we did, amen, I don't have to go back and wonder, because we cast out demon from a young girl. I don't have to go and wonder what, amen, hallelujah, what, amen, they do to me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, I feel the pain, I feel the hurt. Hallelujah. But will you carry your hurt all the years? Will you carry it over all the time?
Hallelujah.
My friend, amen, you got to get rid of that hurt.
Amen.
Amen. Woman, you've been hurt by a man who say he love you, but you don't have to carry that hurt. Amen. Amen. Mother, you've been hurt with your children, but you don't have to carry. Young lady, you've been abused, amen, from since you was a young child. Amen. In that home that you grew up with, in that family, young man, you've been abused, but you don't
have to carry it anymore, because there is a hope in Christ. You can take, amen, hallelujah, you can open your heart this morning and say, I don't carry it. Oh, amen, I don't carry that burden, I will carry that care. Don't get it in your future, my friend. Hallelujah. And Paul and Silas teach us a lesson, Pastor Blackman. In spite of any situation, we can rejoice and be glad. Always sing song of praise unto the Lord. Do you know that when you begin to praise God, you tap into heaven, and heaven began to flow upon you? Amen. Paul and Silas tap into heaven in songs and praises. That's why he said, let your moderation be known unto all men. Hallelujah. The Lord is at hand. Let them know, amen, Jesus is coming. Let them know, let them give. Let me give them a hope that is in you. Amen. Stop worrying, my friend. Stop carrying that weight. Start carrying, amen, and bother about what people say. Amen. Life must go on.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And Pastor Blackman, when I look at Paul and Silas in that prison, hallelujah. Amen. Some of us don't even reach that stage.
Amen. No. Amen. Amen.
I mean, I can see some people just sitting home.
Yeah.
Every time you begin to worry, you tie up yourself. You're starting to build wall around you. And that's the reason. And some of you may call in and say, Pastor, pray for me.
Yeah.
But the prayer may not work, because you got to know,
amen,
that the cares that you're carrying, you got to learn to let it go,
amen,
on Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
He is your burden bearer. And unless you let it go, hallelujah,
yes,
you would not be free.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because last week we said, somebody stretching the hand to you.
Yes.
And said, come, give me that load, my daughter. Give me that load, that son, my son. Come, bring it to me. And yet still we hold it on.
Yeah.
And we still say, come and help me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. When he's right there to take it.
Amen.
My friend Paul and Silas in that prison, they commit the cares to Jesus.
Yes.
They commit that load to Jesus. They commit that hurt and that pain to Jesus. And as they begin to tap into the secret of the power, you see, amen, the secret to release the power of God is praises.
Amen.
It's praises. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Open your heart and give him praise this morning. Hallelujah. And what happened there, Pastor Blackman? Is that heaven began to come down.
Amen, amen.
The Bible says, amen, two or not shall agree in touching anything. And there are two men inside thee. They began to touch something that,
hallelujah,
amen, that no human being could ever help them. And heaven come down and shaken that,
amen,
prison cell and loose. And people that is, there's prisoner that was on the other cells, and them, the prison door was loose.
Amen.
I want to give you that revelation this morning.
Hallelujah.
Mother, you're praying for your children, but you're carrying the load.
Amen.
Amen. You're praying for your family, amen, for your husband, but you're still looking at all he's doing.
Hallelujah.
And carrying his load. Hallelujah. That prison cell that he, amen, that the devil seemed to bung him in would never loose until you begin to, amen, look beyond his fault.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And
hallelujah,
see the real need of your husband.
Yes.
Read the real need of your wife, sir, until
hallelujah,
you see the real need of your children. Hallelujah. Stop looking at the children attitude. Stop looking at this young man who go in and take job. Stop looking and complaining to your neighbor, complaining to your church brother and your sister.
Come on, stop complaining. Amen. God hate complaining. Hallelujah. But God love a heart that is cheerful. A Amen. Heart that would rejoice in him. In spite of the situation, I will lift my head unto the hill yes. from whence cometh my help. Amen. Oh God. My Amen. Help cometh from the Lord. I feel the joy of the Lord is flowing. I will speak it, my friend. I want you to receive Amen. It this morning. The joy of the Lord. Amen. Let it go this Hallelujah. Morning. Let it go. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. We learn a lesson in that with Paul and Silas. And amen. Listen to me. The time that Paul and Silas were taken to worry, they put it in prayer.
Into prayer, amen.
And praises.
Much more profitable.
And well, you know what happened?
Amen.
That the whole prison and all the prison yes. door, this big iron gate,
yes.
broke loose.
Yes.
The prisoner heard them. Amen. The man that were guarding them fell asleep.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And that's what I want to give you this morning. We want to give you that word this morning. Instead of you looking at the situation, put it on Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
And rejoice for the deliverance.
Amen.
Rejoice. Amen. Because God, hallelujah, know how to reach them. God know where to take them.
Amen.
But you're going and complaining about your problem, and you're complaining about how much the bill is coming up, and you can't get a job. Every time you say you can, you confess defeat.
Amen.
You confess that you can.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. If God say, hallelujah, amen, that he supply all my need according to his riches in glory, is God a liar?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. If God say amen, that amen, by his stripe I am healed, is God a liar?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Stop thinking about and worrying about that cancer, that diabetic, that glaucoma, that things that affect your eye, and lift your spirit, amen, and let the devil know that your victory in Christ, he had defeated the work of him on the cross of Calvary.
Hallelujah.
Oh, when he gave up the ghost, he said, it is finished.
Amen.
It is finished. Man, redemption is accomplished.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And all the package that accompanies salvation eternally, amen, is accomplished. Oh my God. Just
Hallelujah.
Remember what Calvary means to you. Let's remember what, amen, the cross means to you. What took place on the cross for me, sir. Amen. And rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice. Hallelujah. You want your children prison door to open?
Hallelujah. Start rejoicing.
Put aside those cares and start Amen. To praise God.
Amen. Amen.
Because when you begin to praise God, you connect to heaven, and heaven glory will come down and reach
Amen.
Them wherever they are. And God will deliver them.
Amen.
And you will have much more to rejoice.
Hallelujah.
Stop worrying.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Stop worrying.
Praise the name.
You give
of
them Lord. Jesus, and
yes.
that's sufficient.
Hallelujah.
You give it over.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Leave it in God's hand.
That's right.
We can't help God in his work. God does not need any consultation. You know, many times, Pastor Elliot, we think God needs some assistance. You know, I'm going to give it into God's hand, but God is working too slow for me. We don't verbalize it, but our behavior
Fear.
Demonstrates
Fear.
That we believe God is working too slow.
Yeah.
And so we want to get it done so quickly, but it is all about God's timing.
Mm-hmm.
Not your timing, not my timing, not the pastor's timing. It's about God's timing. And once you turn it over to God, God will take care of it.
Yes. You know, sometimes we slow down the process.
Yeah.
By worrying and taking on the problem, you slow the process
Amen.
Of God.
Amen.
And you build yourself a prison cell.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You know, we had a game in Grenada we used to play. We used to play a game. And people, I want you to listen. Sometimes that's the game we play. We used to call it Yango. You're giving somebody something, and as soon as you reach their hand,
yes,
you pull it back.
Yes.
As soon as you reach and you pull it back, and the person starting to get angry. And this is the attitude of some people that is listening to me today.
Amen.
They give it to God, but they're pulling it back.
Yeah.
So they always have it. They say, yes, God, take it now. And, you know, you're provoking God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Listen to me, my friend. It is 8:54 in the house. This segment, amen, is finishing at 9. Bishop Anderson is coming. Hallelujah, at 9 o'clock. But I want you this morning to really, really make a decision in your life and give up that king.
Amen.
Give up that worry. Give it up and start to lift your heart and praise God.
Amen.
Take a lesson from Paul and Silas in the prison cell and rejoice. Rejoice. And again, I say rejoice. And in the end of this scripture that we read, hallelujah, it said, and the peace of God that passeth all understanding shall keep your heart and mind to Christ. The Amen. Peace. You cannot have peace.
Yes.
By worrying. But you can have peace by rejoicing.
Two doesn't work together.
Yeah. Hallelujah. His brother, his two sisters, joy and peace. Hallelujah. Praise God Glory this morning. God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We thank you this morning. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. We give God thanks this Amen. Morning. Hallelujah. We will be back with you again next week. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We're going to be back with you next Saturday morning at 8 a.m. sharp. Praise God. You tell your neighbors, say, invite a friend to listen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Choice Radio, 92.9 FM. Hallelujah. It's your life. It's your choice.
Amen.
And it's your salvation.
And you want to get us off the air? You can take this number down.